Imagine a future moment in your life where all your dreams come true. You know, it's the greatest moment in your life when you get to experience it with one person. Who's standing next to you? So we lie here
in the dark. Our dreams are gonna come true, Lucas. I'm so sorry. I didn't want this for you.
Peyton, I hate you.
You're always saving me.
Somebody's got to.
To be with you. Just to be with you.
You still love me, don't you?
Lucas Scott, will you get a prom with me?
Absolutely.
It's always gonna be there, isn't it? You and me.
Do you not feel what I have felt every day that we've been apart for the last 3 years? Because I have felt there is this vital piece of me that's been missing.
It's okay. Go.
It's you.
What?
When all my dreams come true, the one I want next to me, it's you. It's you, babe.
I've been holding this in for a really long time. I just need to know. I love you. I'm in love with you.
I can't live without you, babe.
We are gonna live happily ever after.
I loved you since the first time I saw you. I love you. I always have, and I always will.
We've been through so much together. And despite how confused I've been or lost I might have gotten, there was always you finding me and saving me.
Peyton! Stay with me.
Come on, you promised. Where's Scott got you?
Scared me. I am so terribly in love with you. And I always will be.
But you saved me with the words you wrote about me in your novel.
The boy saw the comet. And suddenly his life had meaning. You're a mess, Lucas Scott. But you're my mess.
I am so in love with you.
I love you too, Peyton.
In that moment, my triumph was not a state championship, but simple clarity. The realization that we had always been meant for each other, and every instinct to the contrary had simply been a denial of the following truth. I was now, and would always be, in love with Peyton Sawyer.